Beloved friends, this is a matter of joy that we all are here together in this company to share the wisdom from the sands of time. I take this opportunity to speak to you from the wisdom from the sands of time. Death is bliss. A blissful death becomes samadhi. When death is a relaxation, it is indeed the real relaxation. Deep inside you surrender. You welcome the moment of annihilation. You have known life and now you want to know death as well. Death is bliss. Death is celebration. Death is samadhi. Death is celebration for the one who is dying, and also it should be celebration for those around. At the moment when a blissful one is dying, tremendous energy is released. If you are available to this energy, you can attain to enlightenment that very moment. I repeat this. At the moment when a blissful one is dying, tremendous energy is released. If you are available to this energy, you can attain to enlightenment that very moment. However, this never happens. Only a rare one dies singing and dancing, full of awareness. When a person dies, he looks beautiful and silent too. This does not mean that the person died in silence or full of beauty and ease. Very rarely does a person die beautifully, full of gratitude, bliss and harmony. 99% of people struggle tremendously before death actually happens. And in fight, great stress arises. Such is the story of almost everyone. Rare is the one whose death is celebration. A master, a sheikh, a Buddha, his death is a celebration. His life is a celebration. And death is the culmination of that life that has attained to fruition. Just imagine a small ant crawling on your body or a small thorn in your foot and how uncomfortable you become. A small headache, stomach is a little disturbed, and how much do you become concerned? Just imagine. Now the body and soul are disintegrating and the body is being taken apart. The soul cannot exist then. With the body you have become so involved that in the process you have forgotten that soul too exists. You have forgotten that you are a soul. The flowering of the soul has not yet happened. And now the body is disintegrating. You lament. Soul needs the body to blossom and spread its fragrance. Body is known and soul remains unknown to you. And now you are being taken apart, you cling to the body. The known. You cannot leave claims with body. It is difficult, indeed very difficult. Therefore, very reluctantly, fighting, struggling and crying, yet unwillingly you leave the connection with body, but nobody can see it. It is something inside you, and only you can see it. You cannot even say anything at that moment. You die in misery. Only a few people, the rare one, the Master, the Buddha, dies blissfully. A blissful death becomes samadhi. When death is a relaxation, it is indeed real relaxation. Deep inside you surrender. You welcome the moment of annihilation. You have known life, and now you want to know death also. You have lived life. You have enjoyed every moment of it. A great trust has arisen in you about life, and you know death is the culmination of life. Therefore, death is the crescendo of life. If life is a yajna, then death is the final offering in the sacrificial fire. It must be beautiful. It must be blissful. When the whole journey has been beautiful, why not the end? Why not the goal? There is no reason to be afraid. When the whole journey has been such a tremendous joy and fulfillment, why not the end as well? It is the culmination. You have come home. You welcome death. You are ready to embrace death. You relax. You simply slip into death like a dewdrop slipping from the leaf into the lake. Plup. And the dewdrop slips from the leaf into the lake. And that is the moment. If you can die without any fight, you do not die indeed. This is annihilation, or what Sufis call it, fana. This is the first step. Annihilation is followed by subsistence in God or Baka. Together these lead to resurrection, as Christians call this. You enter the unknown knowingly, willingly and blissfully, and you are never born again then. You have simply slipped out of the body confinement or the world. You live eternally, but then you live as an unembodied existence with no limitations and no boundaries too. The body gives you a boundary. With body indeed comes the limitations too. Death takes away all boundaries and limitations from you. Body gives you a definition. It gives you the boundaries of mind and intellect. Body makes you a man or a woman. Body makes you ugly or beautiful. Another dimension of the body, mind, makes you intelligent or unintelligent. Thus, body-mind realm makes you this and that. And you are defined. Death takes away all definitions and finiteness too. It simply leaves life undefined. Life undefined is what God is. Life undefined is what God is. But to know this kind of death, you will have to know life as well, or you have to know God. So next time when a beautiful moment passes by, think in terms of life. What a beautiful moment to live and dance and be alive. Then one day when death comes, you will say same to death, what a beautiful moment to die. What a beautiful moment to die. All moments are beautiful. Only you have to be receptive and surrendering. All moments are blissful. Only you have to be capable of seeing the beauty of it. All moments are benedictions. Only you have to develop such understanding. If you can accept with a deep gratitude, nothing ever goes wrong. If you accept with a deep gratitude, nothing ever goes wrong. This is what Jesus did when on the cross. This is what Jesus did while on the cross. One moment he was full of complaints. Father, why have you forsaken me? Father, why have you forsaken me? And the next moment, total relaxation happens. And next moment, total relaxation happens. Full of ecstasy and gratitude for all that their existence has been to him, Jesus proclaims. Full of ecstasy and gratitude for all that the existence has been to him, Jesus proclaims, let thy will prevail. Let thy will prevail. This is the moment Jesus attains to that which remains unborn. The experience of that which is unborn was already in him. Now Jesus, the experience attains to totality. Fana or annihilation merged into one another to create resurrection. Embodied soul became disembodied. Jesus is resurrected. And then the disembodied self appears as embodied self. And then the disembodied self appears as embodied self. This is what happened to Jesus when he was resurrected. And only a devoted one, Mary Magdalene, saw it. This is ultimate in life and death too. Only this much for this talk.